Megha here from Republic TV. My question is for both Alankrita and Ekta. I have two questions. One, what is the distribution plan of this movie when we have three other movies releasing on the same date? And secondly, an elderly woman recently from Meghalaya was asked to leave from a golf club because of her dress, and she was wearing a traditional Khasi dress, which is considered to be a maid uniform. So what do you have to talk about this particular issue wherein, you know, how long for us to end chauvinism and...
How long? Does anyone have an answer? Patapat bata do, mujhko bhi batao. I'm dying to know how long. I've been waiting for so many years now. I want to know.
I've entered a temple with a half pant, and I'm told two other men who've entered with like same length of pants. It's okay, but I'm not allowed to show my this part of the leg also, which is like it happens all the time. I mean, and clearly this is a situation that we have to constantly combat. That's what I say. It happens to us every day. And your shoulder showing here, aap decently dressed nahi hai. Wo decent word kaise aa jata hai, mujhe pata nahi chalta. As far as the release goes, we're planning 400, 500 screens. We'll push it as much. And we are hoping to create as much noise. This is a film that is very close to my heart. And I will do everything in my power to give it the widest release, the rest.
Thank you.
Alankrita, recently Pehlaj Nilani said that, you know, if he got a lakh of votes, he would allow the word intercourse in Jab Harry Met Sejal. Did you wish he'd started some voting system for your film as well?
I didn't know that these new kind of laws can be made at any time. I thought that we are following the 1952 Cinematograph Act. If there's been some change, I have not been informed. I don't know. Has there been some sort of change? I have no idea.
You, of course, are a very commercially successful producer. A film like this with an A certificate, and even your trailer's A certificate. So, you know, it can't be shown on TV, and you'll have restrictions. You know, even playing the trailer out. Was there ever a consideration before backing the film?
Do I look like it made a difference to me? In my whole life, I've done things because I believe in it. And sometimes I've been wrong. Sometimes I've been horribly right. Sometimes I've been terribly wrong. I've been panned. But I've lived life according to my own rules. And since I've been backed by my family, I've been able to do that. And I hope I get a chance to get more and more women to do that for the next generation. I hope I can help a lot more women to live the life they want, like I have been able to.
Hi, Ratna. Here, Soumya from Times Now. Firstly, the trailer looks amazing. Congratulations on that. And my question is, it is not very, usually we don't see, women of all ages expressing their feelings and desires. I mean, and even when it is about the young girls. And this movie does it without any age bars. So what do you have to say about that?
About time that people figured out that, you know, we are not dead. Just because you happen to have a few white hair doesn't mean you are dead. So, yeah, I mean, people have desires all through their lives, emotional, sexual, all kinds of desires. And the fact that this kind of a story could be told and was even thought of, I don't think it would have been possible 4 years ago, 5 years ago. The fact that Alankrita did and that we are here today with this film means that things, something is going right. So we are getting to tell different kinds of stories.
Alankrita, my question goes to you. Why the trailer has been so hard-hitting?
Well, the reason that the trailer has been so hard-hitting is that I've had a very hard-hitting kind of journey. And I think I'm done with the niceties. We've been very soft and kind and all of that. But I think I'm really done with that. Because, you know, we had a very warm, like, graphic image that we had used earlier when we had for international... for the international festivals and all of that. But I think time's really up on that. We applied for the census certificate at the end of December. We got it in our hands on the 3rd of June. And on the 5th, we announced the release. So it took me almost 6 months to get a film certified. I think I'm allowed to come out with a trailer that's hard-hitting because also I feel that what happens to the characters in the film is exactly what... happened to the film. It was like, if women want to express themselves, they should just be told to shut up and stay at home and not show their film in theaters. So I think that there's a real parallel between what women experience and what actually the film experienced. And that's the reason we came out with this trailer. And also I think that it's really important for people to go out into the theater to watch this film, because otherwise it's like, what was that whole battle for? And as citizens of India, are we really interested in listening to women's stories? Are we interested in freedom of expression? And I should think that the fact that this film is releasing is not just about, you know, like the people behind the film, but the fact that it's important that the film has is managing to release.
21st.
Hi, Ekta, this is Priyanka. Hi. I wanted to know that, do you sometimes feel guilty of reinforcing stereotypes around women through TV shows?
Never, because if you see the kind of women I've shown on television, they just wear a sari. They may have OTT makeup, but OTT and the level of makeup is your own personal desire again. But nowhere in any of my shows have any of the women touched their husband's feet, called them Parmeshwar. We have tackled marital rape, domestic violence. It's the only problem is that they wear saris and they look traditional. And you know what? For a lot of women, the battles we take on TV are real. So if you go through this Boston research that was carried out for television in India between 2001 and 2005, and it's an independent research, one of the most valued researches worldwide, they will tell you that a lot of women in Indian homes who never had a stand in family matters, actually after Tulsi and Parvati, were allowed to discuss or take part in family decisions, because if they could, why can't they? So clearly, there have been different battles. Some are very, very strong and very, very loud. And some of them have to be, you see, if I show a woman wearing different clothes, speaking a different language, I may not be able to have an identification with the woman, because she feels there's a different woman's story. Today, when you actually have somebody who is probably of a certain mindset, she speaks your language, and she goes and takes that battle on, you feel more and more attached to that battle. As a woman, it's a small thing, but in none of our shows, we have tried to show any kind of patriarchy. In fact, we've made very, very strong women characters, and our men are pretty much there for, which a lot of people say, for the eye candy.
Ekta, what I want to ask is, why didn't you just go ahead and just put it up on your platform of Alt Balaji and just give Pehla Jinlali the lipstick? That sense, you know, that you could bypass.
Because it's not about Pehlaj Nirani, sir. I mean, why are we constantly coming back to this question? I am not, it's like, this is not, you are trivializing my battle, my friend. Our battle, your battle. This is so much more. This is about you going back to your own home. It's not about taking on the CBFC. I, in fact, want to say this. I have no problem with Pehlaji. I respect him. He has a point of view, and I may or may not agree, but that's not the conversation here. At this present moment, we're discussing a society and ideology, and she, like ma'am said, patriarchy. It's got nothing to do with that at all. Institution of yes.